Okay, Boker Tov, it's okay? Good to start? Good morning, Boker Tov. The breakfast is generously sponsored by my parents, Sammy and Stella Imar, in memory of Hanania Imar. And we have a birthday today, I think, right, Amos? We have a birthday today? Ad Mea Vesrim. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
We celebrated you at 2 o'clock in the morning.
How old him? 29?
I went dancing last night.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
I went to Georgetown.
Okay.
You're 29 plus, right?
So guys, we're continuing. We're continuing on the theme of tefillah, prayer, and we are following Rav Shimon Schwab. And those who are, before we get into the next bracha that we're talking about, if you know, we're going to the Seder, the order of the brachot in the morning, and today we're going to focus on Birkat Elohai Neshama. But before we get into that, those who were here yesterday on Shabbat know that we talked about prayer with Moshe Rabbeinu and how he prayed 515 times. And there's, I just wanted to end on one thing I neglected to say yesterday, which is when you pray so hard for something, and whether you, if you don't get it, the question is, where do those tefillot go? Where do those prayers go? The prayer of Moshe Rabbeinu, you know, one of the biggest tzaddikim we ever had in our people, 515 times, where did those tefillot go? So the rabbis, they tell us something really, really beautiful that we read every Shabbat morning. It says, it's a tehillim that we say, Tefila le Moshe, Isha Elohim. Anyone want to continue? Adonai, Ma'on Atayitaranu. What's Ma'on?
Like a house.
A house, a house, or a chest. I've heard it described as a chest. What does a chest do? It stores things. So the tefillot of Moshe Rabbeinu, 515 different tefillot that he did to pray to go into Eretz Yisrael, did they just disappear? No, he didn't get this tefillah answered. No, they didn't. They went into this ma'on, this chest, that would be held in the future. And this tefillot would protect Am Yisrael in the future. So whenever, literally, the Jewish people needed a bracha to save them through whatever moment in history, the chest would be opened and a prayer of Moshe Rabbeinu would be grabbed, if you will, metaphorically, to protect the Jewish people throughout history. Okay, so I thought that was a beautiful ending to where do the tefillot go when you pray for something and it doesn't materialize, at least in front of your eyes. Those tefillot do not go in vain. They are stored in a chest, in a ma'on, bizrat Hashem, for you and your family for the future.
In
okay.
Storage.
Okay, Birkat Elohai Neshama. As you know, last week we focused on Asher Yatzarat Adam, which really thanked Hashem 2 weeks ago, which thanks Hashem for the marvels and the wonders of the human body, the physicality of the human. Now we're going to flip-flop over to the Neshama, right? And it literally says, Elohai Neshama Shnatatabi, my God, the soul you placed in me. So the wording of this bracha in the first person singular, Shnatatabi, right? As it literally me, is uniquely personal. Every person has a soul that is unique to them. And just like it says in Bereshit, in chapter 2, verse 7, it says, Ve'afach ve'apav nishmat chayim, Hashem blew into his nostrils a living soul, who? Adam HaRishon, right? The Zohar HaKadosh, it says a commentary on this, it says, Man denafach mitoche nafach, which means if one blows into another, he breathes something of himself into that person, right? So therefore, the neshama is something that Hashem personally has given to us and literally has blown into us, right? And then the bracha goes on, Tehora hi, is pure. Since Hashem is holy and pure, we, of course, our neshama is holy and pure. Now, the neshama, it remains pure no matter how much you taint it. No matter how many averot you do, the neshama remains pure. Right? The most wicked of peoples in the world, the Jewish, the neshama remains pure. The person, of course, has averot, but the neshama is pure. No one can touch it. Now, this is very different from the most prevailing religion in the world, which says what? It says at the core of its belief that man has a sinful soul. Right? This is Christianity. That man has a sinful soul, and that therefore he is condemned to Geinom, the cell, unless he accepts certain beliefs. We totally reject this philosophy. We believe that we are pure, our neshama is pure, it comes directly from Hashem. Now, one should be aware that the neshama is, of course, very unique, and no two neshamot are alike. Now, The wording of this bracha describes the neshama in four different ways. Listen to this. And they correspond to the four different worlds we have, right? There are four different worlds before we get to the top. Here are the four. It's Tehorahi, Ata Verata, Ata Yitzarta, and Ata Nefachtabi. Now what are those? Tehorahi refers to the origin of the neshama, where the neshama comes from, which is Olam Hatzilut. It's the purest of pure. It's the highest world. Then we come down one world, Ata Verata, which means you have created it. What does it mean? Ye'ish me'ayin, from nothing. You created the neshama from nothing, right? And that's the next level, which means Olam HaBeriyah. Next, you have the third world, which means Ata Yitzartah, which means you have formed it. You've made my personal neshama to fit me. And only I have this neshama, and it's unique to me. This refers to the third world, which is Olam HaYetzirah. Okay, and then we get to the fourth world, which is corresponding to the bracha Ata Nefachtach Bi, which means you have breathed it into me. What does that mean? You've given me life. This is the fourth and final stage of the creation, which is Olam HaSiya, which is the world that we live in today. There are three other worlds above us. We live in Olam HaSiya. And so as long as HaKadosh Baruch Hu allows me to have the Shema, we are here. The second he takes it away, God forbid, we leave. Okay? And then the bracha continues, Ve'ata mishartach bekirbi, which means, and you keep it within me. Last week we talked about this. Amazing how many holes and crevices we have in our body that the neshama just doesn't get out. It holds. Like we know if we had a balloon, like we said yesterday, you put a small hole in the balloon, the air goes out. It's amazing that the neshama stays in. And then the bracha continues, Ve'ata atid litila mimeni. It says, you will one day take my neshama from me. Which, although we say this every single day, and it's not such a happy thought, right? It's talking about our eventual demise. It doesn't make us afraid because we also know that right after this, we continue the bracha. It says, Ula hazira bi le'atid level, which means you will return it to me at some time in the future. When is that future? In the resurrection of the dead, which we call tichiyat hamitim, when the resurrection of the dead will happen. And then the bracha continues, Kol ziman she'aneshama bikirbi. As long as the soul is within me, every moment of my existence in this world. And then it continues, Mode ani lefanecha Adonai Elohai v'Elohai Avotai. It means, I gratefully thank you, Hashem, my God and the God of my forefathers. So when we say Mode here, it's not in the usual Mode, like thank you. It means really Mode bishtar, which means meaning, I acknowledge a fact. What are you acknowledging? You openly acknowledge that you, Hashem, are Ribon Kol HaMa'asim, which means what? You're the master of the world. You created everything, right? You are that of Olam HaSiya, the physical universe, from the most complex and largest of creatures to the smallest gnat, right? Or fly. And then it continues, the bracha, Baruch Ata Hashem, HaMachazir Nechshamot Nifkarim Betim. And it goes on again to continue, blessed are you Hashem who restores souls to dead bodies. Now we conclude this bracha by confirming our belief in Tichiyat HaMitim, which means the resurrection of the dead. So to us, our daily awakening is really a small taste of Tichiyat HaMitim. We already talked about that last 2 weeks ago. When we sleep, it's like we're dead and we arrive every morning. We awake every single morning, just like a resurrection of the dead. Now, we'll end on this. If one forgot to say the bracha, forgot to say this bracha, Elohai Neshama, and he's already completed the Shemoneh Esrei, he's already did the Amidah, does he have to say it because he forgot it? No, because in Shemoneh Esrei, it literally says, Baruch Ata Hashem Mihayi HaMitim. It's the second bracha we say, which already confirms that that we believe that there is Tichiyat HaMitim. So Bezrat Hashem, next week we're going to go on. I know it was a little short, but the next section is going to be talking about next week, the 15 brachot that we're going to say Birkat HaShachar. And there's amazing, amazing information on that. Bezrat Hashem, we'll tackle it next week. Have a beautiful and peaceful day.